Good afternoon, my friends. Brian with VetteSource here, where today we are inside the truck. I just call this the truck, or in other words, Brutus. This would be our 8.1 crew cab, long bed dually that we resurrected last year. I don't really make too many videos on this one simply because I've been focusing some of the other things we're doing. We also have to finish our Yukon over there anyway. But regardless, this one needs a little bit of troubleshooting, electrical troubleshooting that I've been playing with. And one of the things I've been doing is utilizing different scan tools. Now this truck, when I received it, was completely torn apart. The engine, transmission, were laying in the bed of the truck, kind of unceremoniously just dumped inside a shed and left for dead. So as we put it back together again, and again, as a testament of the 8.1s, this was basically a no prep. I cleaned it up a little bit, pressure washed the engine, reassembled the Allison to the transmission, and threw it in the engine compartment, and it started right up. However, there were a few little quirks that needed to be figured out, and I'm still messing down to the last one. So I've kind of identified, I know what codes this is throwing, and I know what I've changed out. Most of the components have been changed. We're down to a few minor components, but the good folks over at Foxwell sent me this NT301 here to test out and kind of show you guys how it works here on the channel. So this is a sponsored video, of course, because they sent this to me for free, but I figured what we do is put this to the test on the dually here, the one-ton dually, to show you and see if it can identify the codes that I already know are in the system. So I've already got this hooked up to our OBD2 connector here, conveniently located under the dash. You just plug that straight in. And then what we're going to do is, of course, it actually comes with a very nice instruction manual that gives us details of what's in here. Of course, there's a few things that are not, don't translate grammatically over from offshore to English, but they do make a pretty good effort about it. So of course you got safety messages, quickly learn how to use it, good features on what these buttons do, the instruction or the menu, the table of contents, and then using the manual and introduction, getting started, and then our OBD2 operations. This also does EOBD, which I'm not as familiar with that one. And of course this gives us all the different functions it can do. Why is my phone not? That's interesting. Okay, so we've got real-time data. Let's see on the light if that's a little bit better. Real-time data, freeze frame, stored DTCs. So it actually gives us a whole lot of information to work with and is basically a pretty good tool. Shows how to read the codes, obviously. Shows us about erasing the codes, viewing live data, which is a really convenient feature because you can see in real time what your sensors and other items are doing. View the freeze frame, which will take a picture, basically a snapshot of what they're doing at a particular time to see which one maybe is failing. We've got the IM readiness status data, and these are the monitors, readiness monitors. The O2 monitors test, which a lot of times you've got O2 monitors which go bad on these. And let's get through here, let's see what we've got. And this will also actually identifies the protocol this vehicle uses, what type of CAN bus system it is, and also the make and manufacturer of the vehicle. Let's see here. The component test, you can also do individual components. You can request the vehicle information and modules present, DTC lookups. Because like this truck here has a transmission module, control module, and a PCM control module. And the review data. So there's lots of stuff on here. So let's just kind of real world show what this thing will do and see what happens. So let's put this over here. So we've got our menu there, which our menu is obviously OBD2. I do not know why my phone's not focusing in, guys. It's really weird. OBD2, DTC lookup, review, print data, about, and then setup. So let's go ahead and we'll do review. Oh, I've got to hit the button. There we go. So we are reviewing the data. Oh, that's because I don't have it running. Let's go ahead and start it up. And let's see if it'll reset for me. Let's review. Okay, now that's odd. Let's unplug this and plug it back in again, see what it does. All right, we reset it. All right, well, this is making a monkey out of me. Oh, that's why. Because I'm only supposed to go to review once I have data in the system. So, it's actually going through. Okay, so we've got mill status is on. I've got one code found, and I do not want to erase my previous data. So I've got, let's read our codes. All right, so we want a, this is a Chevrolet truck. And there we go. U2105, huh, that's interesting. Let's see what we find under pending codes. No pending codes are stored in the system. Now, it did it for me just a minute ago, but for some reason, it's not pulling up. Let's try this one more time. Maybe it's because we're not on our second ignition cycle. This truck is giving me a code 1571 and a 0700, which is simply just telling me that there's a code stored in the transmission control module, which is the P1571, which is our requested torque signal. So let's see if it'll read this again. All right, so we've got two codes, and what we're gonna do, we do not want to erase the data. Let's go ahead and read these codes. And we want the stored codes. And manufacturer specific codes are found. And we're going to go ahead and select Chevrolet. Okay, so there's our P0700 diagnostic code. And there's our P1571. So it did recognize it. Because what it does, it throws them on the second ignition cycle. So already, we found the benefit of this. Because if you're in the dark and you're not sure what your vehicle's doing, especially CAN bus, OBD2 systems, this is going to help you quite a bit. So what we're going to do is go back to our live data. This reminds me, actually, of the older MT2500 snap-on scan tools. Data set. Let's look at that. Okay, so it is showing me fuel system 1 and 2 out of limits, which is odd. Load PCT, we've got ECT. IAT signal, spark advance, vehicle speed sensor, RPM, which is reading correctly. Map. OBD sensors, O2 sensors. A lot of information actually in here that can be read with this tool. I'm just curious to see what this will do. Now I can record the data also. And I can record the Plink data set. And let's go ahead and do a manual trigger on that, location 1. And we're gonna start recording. So what it's doing now, it's recording this data to show me what's going on. And then when I want to stop, I'll go back. And then I don't want to record it right now. I don't want to play it. Well, let's play it back right now. And there we go. See? Quite cool. This is a pretty good tool, I have to admit, guys. This does quite a bit, gives you quite a bit of information that the other are, that you pay a lot more money. Now, this tool, I believe, is under $100. So this is actually pretty cool. Let's go ahead and see if our IM monitors are ready. And okay, I do not have a cat monitor on this one because it's a commercial vehicle. Evap also is not. Air O2, okay. So when you go for a check at, when you're giving, when you're doing your inspection, they're gonna look for, I think you have to have four readiness monitors, I believe, four or five readiness monitors before it'll pass you. And you can see we have actually five of these on. I think that was it, but I may be misquoting there. But we got O2 monitor test. Let's see what it does there. Thresh counts. Gives us the counts. Okay. I would have to say this is a pretty good system here, guys. And it's really inexpensive. So if you're in the dark about what you've got going on with your vehicle, the selected mode is not supported, okay? It's really going to be something that's going to be quite useful for you. We've got vehicle information. Let's see what vehicle information it gives me. I don't want to do that yet. Let's see about the modules. Let's see what the modules tells me. Protocol, SAE, okay. There's a little bit of technical jargon in this that if you're not familiar with it, you're going to have to read through it. Good thing is it'll actually tell you how to look up. Okay. Let's see what it does for us here. Okay, enter, confirm. That's weird, it kind of took me back to there. Traction control torque request circuit. Okay, I know that already. Okay, so. Okay, and then let's see if we can review our data here. I keep forgetting this is not a it's not a touchscreen. I keep forgetting that. Okay, and that's the live data that I recorded before. So, you know, guys, I'm going to give this a thumbs up because I really do like this as far as even if you're not able to do a lot of your own repair work, with this tool, you can actually verify what the computer is telling you is wrong with the car and kind of give you an idea of what you're working with, point you in the right direction. So many times you get to mechanics, and, of course, they could tell you that your muffler bearings are bad, which don't exist. Now, there we go. Okay, and it tells us which monitors are good. I like that visual right there. So, yeah, I think overall, guys, I'm going to give a recommendation on this tool simply because there's a lot of good stuff on here that can be used, and it's quite handy. And like I said, it'll point you in the right direction if you got to take the vehicle in for inspection or testing or whatever. And, in fact, if you've replaced components on your vehicle to get it back on the road, if you're kind of a an amateur or do-it-yourself mechanic, this will allow you to see if your readiness monitors have gone through what we call the drive cycle when you're redoing things, so that you can tell if they're going to be working or not, or if they're on. Because if they're not on, then it will not pass the state inspection in most states. It'll fail it automatically. Even if it doesn't have a service engine light, it will actually fail the vehicle for not having run the drive cycle. This can verify that the drive cycle has been completed. So yeah, I do like the tool. I'm gonna go ahead and keep this, use this, put this one of my tools in my personal toolbox and use it for supplementing my other larger scan tools that I already have. And we'll see how it goes. So I will be back next week. I got a few videos in the hopper for you guys. I've got to take a brief time out. Got to take care of a health task or health issue real quick. But I'll be back with you guys soon, and we will go back to making pretty frequent content again. So thanks for watching, guys, and we will catch up with you next time. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Let's talk to you then.